the exercise. The main motion, the collaborators here, and anything that you have to say.
Okay, so it's being led by the RCC, Regional Coordinating Council, on board the local assemblies, the AMA, Kwale Klote Municipal Assembly, Abelokuma Central. And also, we have the security agencies supporting us. We have the police, we have the army, we have the navy, prisons. We also have the various companies that operate from the graphic road, including Graphic, is it Garment, Japan Motors, is in Nissan, all of them, all the various companies on this stretch are also supporting us. Okay. Yes.
Okay. So I'd like to know the main motive, why this exercise?
Okay, so this is actually the work of the various assemblies. We've been doing it. But the sheer number of people we have had to deal with is overwhelming. We have people coming in from all the regions of Ghana and even outside of Ghana to operate here, and then they end up selling on the streets, etc. So this exercise led by the RCC is come at the right time because he's been able to galvanize all of us. So that one this morning we do this, then obviously to be left for the assemblies, in the various assemblies here, to continue to make sure that the place stay clean and clear up. Yes.
Were they giving notification before the
Okay, so for example, us as an assembly, it's been a constant engagement. We have engaged the market people here. We have engaged the transport operators. And it is in all our interest that we decongest the streets and then the markets of unauthorized structures to allow a lot of the people that are selling on the streets to sell, to be able to sell from the markets. Yes, and also in the process we have places that we have to green to beautify the city.
What time did this exercise start?
4 a.m. this morning.
4
a.m. We plan to finish at 11, but it looks like we are going to go further than 11. Yeah.
So what actually are you doing here? Removing of the structures?
So now we've been able to identify the structures that are causing obstruction. You see, there used to be, for example, a transfer site here, or a skip. The situation is such that we are not even able to place the skip for them to put the refuse in there. Now, this will afford us opportunity to come, to bring back the skip, so that every refuse in the market can be put in there and is evacuated to the landfill site or wherever they have to go.
Okay, I hope it will be an ongoing exercise, really.
Well, like I said, it is not something that we have left. It's the responsibility of the assembly to do this. We do it constantly. But the sheer number of them and the size of staff we have. And then when you finish one place, you will move to Tudu. You will move to Odona. By the time you come back, the very things you don't want them to do, they've done it all over again. So it has been something that is like persistent. So although we are doing the work, not that many people see. And if you employ more people, you should have the money to pay them. You see, so it's a catch-22 situation. What the RCC and the other agencies have helped us to do this morning, it will be difficult for one assembly to do it on its own. So now that it's been done, ours is to make sure we put people on the ground to make sure we are able to maintain the place. So we are grateful because your presence, the media, is also helping us to create awareness that this sort of thing is not allowed, it's not welcome, and we are not going to allow them to be there. Yeah.
Thank you.
So thank you very much too for your contribution. Yeah.